Hello everyone, my name is Grega Horat and welcome to our new episode of Surfing the Elliott Waves, where I will look at some of the most interesting developments for this week. This video has been brought to you by Orbex. I will take a look at Eurodollar cable, 10-year US notes in connection with yen pairs, and also we'll have a quick look at gold and silver. Well, on Eurodollar we have seen, as you know, recently this break out of this wedge, so I think that the bullish trend is here. However, we may not see a resumption of that trend to any high levels. In fact, I'm looking at this recovery as a free wave corrected move. This is wave A, this was wave B, and now we have ongoing wave C, which should be made by 5 subwaves. Well, what I see here is that we still don't have 5 subwaves, but it looks like that this could be ongoing a five-wave movement within the wedge pattern. In particular, I'm looking at an ending diagonal. Now, ending diagonal, it's a free pattern, which means that each leg is made by three waves. So even first leg, as you can see here, is subdivided by three waves, then you have a three-wave pullback for a wave two. So obviously, I would now expect at least three waves up here into wave three towards this, let's say, this resistance, if I connect this previous swing highs. From this downtrend, I would say that Eurodollar could actually move all the way up to 1.1250. Okay, then you see another pullback and then final stages for this recovery. When it comes to trading, from a trading perspective, this is not any useful development at the moment. Okay, but it can be very interesting maybe for weakness if this ending diagonal interpretation is going to be correct. We are still far away from the completion, but I think it's very interesting to keep an eye on. Here's also an intraday chart. As I said, three waves up for each leg. Now here was this three wave structure, then you have actually not a three wave decline but a seven leg structure for wave two, so it was WXY. Then you have a five waves up for wave B, for wave A, and now I'm expecting more upside from end of a wave B. Okay, now I want to take a look on cable. Now cable is quite interesting. As you know, we have seen a very nice reversal to the downside from this upper trend line resistance. It was a very similar reaction compared to this developments that we have seen at the end of August of last year, when market turned up from the trend line support. And what I see right now is actually that market is breaking this trend line support, so of this upward channel. So I think that actually bears can be in progress. Maybe we will see only a three waves of decline, I'm not sure. Ideally we will see, however, a five wave decline for this wave C, but what is really important is that we may expect more weakness. Looking here at the 4-hour chart, well, I'm expecting more weakness because we have seen a five-wave fall here, and now you have a corrective recovery. Ideally, this corrective recovery is not finished yet, but 61.8% could be a very interesting zone for this downtrend to resume. Now, looking at the 1-hour chart, to update it here really quickly, I think that this could be wave B, okay, and now we will see in this week a reversal higher towards 61.8%, which actually could unfold very similar to euro dollar, which could rise towards 1.1250, I said, I think. Okay, of course there's also always a chance that market goes straight to the downside here, but the reason why I'm looking here at this potential wave count where wave C is still missing is because this recovery was quite sharp and no overlaps within this uptrend. So I like this scenario that we go a little bit higher, because this would also attract a lot more buyers, I think. But actually, as you know, when market moves higher and if a lot of buyers comes in, the opposite may happen. Actually, the market may turn to the downside. In fact, the 61.8% is much more interesting resistance area, fib resistance, than 50% that we just tested recently. Now let's take a look also on the 10-year US notes. Okay, the 10-year US notes has seen a very nice move to the downside, to the upside, very nice reversal last week. So I'm thinking about completion of a wave 4. If that's going to be the case, then you know that fifth wave is in full progress and if fifth wave is really going to lift these prices higher, what we should understand based on intermarket analysis is that the yields will come down and this will also send down yen pairs. Okay, dollar yen is already moving from the highs very aggressively. Same thing with Aussie yen. Okay, so actually we could face some kind of a risk off environment. Also, we have seen Nikkei turning to the downside, which is also very important when you're tracking dollar yen pair. So looking at dollar yen, what I see here is that actually market recently break out of this downward channel. Okay, so it looks like that at least three waves of decline is in progress. Towards 106.40 would be my minimum downside objective. And looking at the 4-hour chart, to give you the full perspective here, this first leg from here to here should be made by 5 subways, and so far that's not the case yet. Okay, this was the high and you have here complex wave 2, sharp wave 3, so I'm expecting maybe simple wave 4 because of rule of alternation. So I'm looking for a wave 4 bounce, which could actually be very interesting for this market to short, okay, to catch the weakness, because I think that yen may see more gains against other currencies in this situation when Nikkei is moving to the downside as well. Here is Nikkei. I know that I'm tracking actually a fourth wave here, okay, but notice that fourth wave should be made by three waves. Okay, it's a corrective leg. So this is first leg, watch out for a bounce and then watch out for a next drop. Okay, and in the meantime, as I said earlier, this 10-year US notes futures, I think, should move even higher, which obviously will cause more downside on dollar yen. Another pair that I would take a look is not only dollar yen, but also Aussie yen. I'm also tracking this one because we recently turned down from this resistance. Notice that market just spiked higher above this resistance, tested 61.8%, and now we are reversing lower. Also, what is important is that market is once again sitting on this trend line, which eventually will be broken. And if I consider what is happening on the 10-year US notes, then maybe this is the real timing for potential more weakness coming. Now, looking at the 1-hour chart, I will and would keep an eye on this wave 2, okay, or maybe wave B. So I'm still looking for this possibly incomplete ongoing decline here. Let me adjust the webcam here a little bit. So I'm still looking for this to be currently maybe minor wave 4, then you get a drop to a new low and then a bounce, and watch out for this free wave recovery within wave 2 before I look for shorts. Looking for any shorts here at this stage, I think it's not offering any good risk reward setup, but I know that probably this is going to be consolidation that will send us to the downside, but definitely I want to look for potential trades after a deeper and much better setup. Okay, I also mentioned that I will take a look at very quickly at gold and silver. So looking at gold here, for our chart, what I really like about gold is that we have seen a very sharp move to the upside. It was probably one of the sharpest waves since market actually broke out of the range in 2019. So I'm thinking about more upside within this current structure away from 1445. You know that I'm tracking here fifth wave. We have been looking for this move to the upside for a while, but this fifth wave should be made by 5 subways. So far we have seen a very nice move above this 1556 highs, so it looks like that maybe we will face a new pullback now and then a final push higher. Keep in mind that we need 5 subways, as I said. So here was wave 1, then you have wave 2, you had a wave 3, now you will have wave 4 and then more upside. Okay, there's also maybe some kind of a gap here that could be filled before a fifth wave resumes to the upside to higher prices. Also, if we take a look very quickly at silver, you will see that silver actually made a very nice move out of this wedge. We have been talking about this a few weeks back, and this appears to be a very nice impulse up into this resistance. Then you have also resistance, not only FIB resistance, but also this swing resistance, first here and a second here. So I think that this whole region is quite important for potential setback. and this setback, at least three wave decline, could go in line perfectly with a fourth wave on gold, and then both should move to the upside, but we will see to which degree actually. Okay, traders, thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Talk to you soon. Bye.